Hi friends, welcome to Tutors Funny channel. Today I am going to teach with the J tree. Okay, this is very important concept. There are many students who asked me to do the J tree Java. Here, this is simple way I have done. Okay, this is here. This is a courses. We have a there are two categories are there. This is the programming, and I think it's a graphic design. Right. Now, if you expand the programming, there are several various programming languages are there. C sharp, Java, ASP.NET, Python and PHP. If you expand the graphic designing, the relevant courses will be there. Okay. So now the what is the purpose of this one? If you are going to any company, it will be easily we have to check the prices and all. What are the courses modules are there? Simply you have to C sharp. If you click on this one, course C sharp, price will be displayed. Java here, ASP.NET, PHP, Python, PHP here, the relevant prices would be displayed over here. It's very simple, right? So that's the purpose we are doing the review, right? So today what I'm going to do is how to do this program step by step, we'll teach today. Okay, if you are, this is the first time you are coming to our channel, please subscribe me. Right, now first let's close it. Now first what I'm going to do is go to the new project. Select Java, Java application, click next. Here what I'm going to do is I'm going to give the project name as course list, whatever name you can give. If it is checked, create main task, you have to uncheck it, click finish. Your new project has been created successfully with the name of course list. You have to click the source package. You have just click on this plus symbol and expand it. Select the course package, right click new JFrame form. You have to give here is the class name course list. Right, click finish. Right, now your JFrame has been created successfully. Now what I'm going to do is here I'm going to go to the palette and drag one label over here, right click edit text. Here I'm going to give the name as course list. This is the heading I'm going to give. Select this again, properties, font property, bold. You have to select as the font size are 36. Font family you have to select as this one. Click OK. If you are feel to increase the size little bit, I'm going to increase it like this. Right. Okay. Now first what I'm going to do is here, I'm going to change the layout. Right. So here, go to the source, Control F, you have to find it. Okay, you have to type the text box UI, press enter key. Here default it come as this, you have to change that metal. This is the actual the look and feel of Java UI design. Okay, this is the actual look and feel here, the actual look and feel of the Java user interface, right? This is the important stuff you have to do. After the when the form is displayed, it should be displayed at the center of the screen. Okay, so click on the frame, properties, code, generate center, close. Now if you execute the program and check whether it's display middle of the screen or not, here it is display middle of the screen successfully. Okay, this is the thing you have to do. Right, now let's close it. Right, now I'm going to go to the palette, drag the J tree here. This is the J tree symbol, right? You just drag and drop. It's a default tree models are there. Okay, this is default tree model. If you run and check, okay, it's a default one. Okay, now what I'm going to do is here, I no need this default one. I right click properties. Here go to the model, tree model, this one. Click on this one. Here click all the fields. I no need this one. Select all. Press delete button. All the things should be deleted. Click OK. Now here, all the things should be deleted. Okay, this all things should be deleted. This is how we have delete the things. Okay, this is must. After that, what I'm going to do is here, after delete all the stuff, let's go to the, this is the project, okay, I have created. I no need to create again by again. So here, first what I did here is, I have created as a default table model. Okay, so you have to write here, go to the source, This is your project, right? Go to the source. So here, this is here, above. This is a construct of the class. You have to write default, what is it? Default tree model. You have to create the object as model. This is not error. It asks to import the package. This is the package it will be coming from. Okay, this is the package it will be reside on the default tree model. Okay, if you click on this one, it will be here. It added there. Okay, that's the thing we have to do. After that, what I'm going to do is here. We have to create another class which is a table the mutable tree nodes, right? What is the class? This class, what is the mention here is, we have to expand the nodes. If you work with all the nodes, nodes mean the nodes. This is the nodes, right? If you execute the program, these all the indicate as a nodes. These are nodes, right? Okay, these nodes we are loading here. That's why we have to write the default multiple mutable tree nodes. Okay, so it will be used to load the each and every nodes. So here, this all the nodes. This all the nodes, right? This is the editing with the nodes. The nodes. Okay. So that let's copy this one. I go here. I'm going to paste it here. Now here this class will be created here, okay? That's the thing, these are courses, okay. Now, after that what I'm going to do is here, this all the nodes, this all the nodes will be loaded, right? When the, when you click run button, this node should be loaded. So how to load the nodes? So what you are going to do is here, I have created one function load, okay? Public load, void load. Okay, so this code I just copy and paste here. I will explain it, no problem. Okay, I have paste it over here. Okay, don't worry about this, all the source code I provide my tutorswani.com website. You will be able to use it. Here I have created the function called load. Start the function and close the function. Inside here we have to create this. Again, we have to create the same thing. Default model. Here we have to create as a design node, default the same thing, this is ID. Okay, after that what I am going to do is here, this is the node object, we have to create the, this all are called as a child nodes. This is a parent, this is a child, okay. So after that we have to create the second one, this one, programming. Here when you run the application, you can check here. This is ID, this is the nodes, okay, this is ID, this is the nodes, right. So if you go for here, this is editing, this is all the nodes, right? So here this is the nodes. Okay, this is programming. Under the program, we have all the nodes. First node, C#, Java, ASP, this is all the nodes. If it is a graphic design, these are the nodes we have written. Okay. After add all the nodes, we have to pass into the JTree. How to pass the JTree? What's the name of the JTree you have created? Default it will be the name JTree1. If you want, you can change the name you want. Right, I leave it as it is, right? So here courses means this is the courses. We have to create a courses object over here. Courses, add this node, you have to add two things. Programming node, this is a programming node we have to add. After that I added the design node, two nodes we have to added, and we have to pass it into the model means this tree model, this tree model equal default, this is a cast it J model, get model, right? This all the nodes we are getting to passing to which we are JTree. So that we have to call via JTree get model. So after that we have to get the get model, set root, we have root this course, right? After that what I deal is JTree set model, we have to set this model into here, right? This all the source code will be reside on the model. This model we are passing here, okay? This without this model we can't load. This model is very important stuff. This table model, right? After done the stuff, this method control C to copy, we have to call inside the constructor of the class. This is the class name course list. Inside the class we have created the constructor, which is a constructor list. It's automatically created. We don't need to create it, okay? So inside here, first it will be load the Intel components. After that we have to load the
if you call this method, whatever what you did in this method within the method, it will be loaded and show you. Okay, if you are executing the program and check here, it will work perfectly well. Now what I'm going to do is here, I just stop it and go to the designs design view. So here I just drag one label over here. This is one label. This is label I'm going to name it as course. Right. Select the label properties, font property, click bold, 24 size. Okay. If you want, you can increase the size if you want. Okay. So that's no problem. Now I'm going to drag another text field. Okay. This one I'm going to name it as txt. Course. Press enter key. I'm going to increase the font little bit bigger. So again, click on this one. Properties. Here the font property bold 80. Okay. Right click. Edit text. Backspace to remove the existing text. Select this. Hold down the shift key down and select both. Control C to copy. Control V to paste here. Get another copy. This one should be the fee. Right click. Select this one. Right click. Edit fee, this one course, this one fee, right click, change variable, txt fee, press enter key, right. This is the thing we have to do, right. Okay, now the course is displayed successfully. When you select the program languages, the relevant, the language name should be displayed on this text field. The relevant course price will be displayed on the price text field. So how to do the task is, how to achieve the text is, select the JTree, right click, you have to go to the event, mouse click event, go here, it will be go to here, this is a mouse click event, okay, JTree view, mouse click. Here what I am going to do is here, the same code, the simple code I have written, I no need to written and explain, it takes too much of time to complete the project, so that I already did run this all the stuff. Control C to copy, Control V to paste here. I will explain it. This one txt course. Right. So here the courses. Courses are coming from where? This is the courses. Default model courses. This is the courses, right? This is the courses. This is the node. Okay, this courses. Okay. So here what I did here is, this is the courses. So you write courses equal default multiple JTree, selected path, get last path component. We have to write like this. Okay, we have to getting the selected value should be displayed on the relevant text field. So after that, what I'm going to do is here, we have to write the text field name. This is the name of the text field, which is a txt course. So we have to write txt course dot set text. We have to set the text, which text you are going to set this text display on here. What is the node you are selected, that which the particular node name should be displayed over here on this text field. So you have to write like this, courses, the default node, get selected path, get class component mean, whatever node you are selected, it assigning to the courses model object. If you are passing courses dot get object to dot string, it will be passing here if you are calling like this. Okay, after that what I am going to do is here, again I am going to do another important stuff is the price should be displayed on the fee text field, the what is the courses you are selected, the price should be displayed based on the courses, what is the course you are selected, the appropriate price will be displayed. So what I did here is, what is the course you are selected, it display on the, it will be assigned to the variable select. Okay, so select equal Photoshop, right? If the courses you are selected as a Photoshop, if the courses you are selected the same name, you have to write, okay? Photoshop, we have to give the price. So you have to write, if the courses you are select equal Photoshop, the price would be displayed on which text field? TXT fee text field. The TXT fee text field. Okay, so you have to give TXT fee set text, we have to give the price. The same task I have did here, CorelDRAW, we have to give the price, InDesign give the price, Illustrator give the price, C Sharp given the price, Java as well, ASP.NET as well, Python and PHP. Likewise, we have given the price. Okay, this simple one we have did in the J mouse clip. Okay, don't worry about that. This also code I will provide in my website. You will be able to download and enjoy it. This is a very essential way to create the JList and how to do the programming. Okay, here it will be worked successfully well. It's working successfully well. It's working successfully well. Okay. Right. Thank you for watching. If you have any doubt on this, you can ask me anytime. If you like my channel, please subscribe me, like me. Thank you for watching.